And I still today am so petrified of, you know, offending her in some way. That if she fires me, I'm like, she's the only person who can like get me to shut up in like 30 seconds. Or even with just a look. She's trained me so well. It's just one look and I'm down. I don't think I'm as cool as my mom.
Yeah,
to be very honest, and my daughter tells me that as well, that you know, if Nani had brought me up, I would be a different person today. So I remember us as kids going to Lonavala, and you know, we were told without a maid, we were told, "Acha, theek hai, y'all have 3 hours. Go and play in the river and come back." Yeah. And nobody came looking for us. 30 minutes, we had to come back for lunch. That was it. So I mean, we never had this. There was and today I cannot even think about telling my son to go alone to the park, which is across the road. My daughter gets followed by the paps, and you know, you have comments posted, and she's had a few, you know, horrible things said to her, etc. And the only thing that you can do at that point of time is to you know, is to counsel them and tell them that, listen, you know, people talk crap.
Two powerful female voices, two powerful female actors. Today I have Renuka Shahane and Kajol joining us for a conversation only on Bollywood Bubble. I can't be happier that one of my first interviews at Bubble features both of you. You know, in my first interview with you, Kajol ma'am, when I came to Bombay, you had said that the role of your grandmother and your mother in your life has been very important. That is also three generations of women in the family. You know, this is also three generations of women that we see. How important were they, and in what ways did they inspire you in life?
My grandmother and my mother, I would say both of them, I had a wonderful childhood for the fact that I had one of the most amazingly, in today's terms, I would say one of the most amazingly feminist childhoods. Because my mom and my grandmom were absolutely like, they were so cool about it. I mean, they went about, and I remember when I started work, actually, that Mickey called me up, Mickey Contractor, and he's like, you know, it's such a relief whenever I call you up and you're not at home and you know, somebody answers the phone, "Ti kamale geli hai." And I was like, yeah, it's just, you know, it's that's exactly what it meant. It was just that she's gone for work. There was no added issue on it, or there was no pressure on it, or no, oh, you know, she's a star and she's gone for shooting or anything like that attached to that. And that's exactly how I look at work till today. And that was taught to me by my grandmother and my mother, that, you know, work has to be a part of your life. There are so many lessons that I've learned from them, driving mostly, how to drive a car, how necessary it is and important it is to drive a car, how important it is to work, how important your independence is, how important your individuality is, and never to lose it. Regardless of whether you work or not, never to lose it in whichever environment you may be in, because it sets the balance and the tone for the rest of your life. So I think I'm very, very grateful that I had these amazing two strong women in my life, and I can never thank them enough. The only thing they didn't teach me was cooking, and I feel that that I can get away with. So
yeah. It's okay.
That's okay. I forgive myself for that. It's fine.
You know, about cooking, I have this theory that cooking is like singing or dancing or painting. It's an art. Okay, not everybody is a painter or a singer or a dancer, because unless you're talented in it, it's not something that you can do very well, you know. So
unless you're talented in it, it's a chore. Yeah.
Exactly.
But you said that you really wanted to be a mother. Like growing up, you wanted to be a mother, Kajol ma'am.
I did. I wanted to be a mom. From the time that I started playing with dolls, I really thought that when I was 8, I would be able to have a baby. Then I thought I would have a baby when I was 12. Then I thought I would have a baby when I was 18. Then by that time, I think my mom gave up on my dad. My dad was happily willing to give me another baby. He was like, if you want a baby, if you want a horse, if you want a dog, whatever you want, I will get it for you. So, but my mom was smart enough to say that, shut up. keep her mouth shut. She's not getting a baby at 12, 8 or 18. So, yeah, so I had to wait a little longer for my own to come along. But yeah, I wanted a baby from the time that I was, you know, I was playing with my dolls. Yeah, I wanted a live one for myself.
You know, our love for our mother is an emotion that's universal. I think, I cannot imagine my life without my mother. But this has a very different, this throws a very different light on that relationship, you know. But I want to know, growing up, of course, there have been rebellious years, right? How many times did you fight, you and your mother, and what did you guys fight on?
I didn't have any rebellious years with my mom. I think my mom was too smart and too cool, and my relationship with my mom is more of she's my sounding board, she's my friend, she's the coolest friend that I have. So I don't know, I didn't go through this phase, and I still today I'm so petrified of offending her in some way, that if she fires me, I'm she's the only person who can like get me to shut up in like 30 seconds or even with just a look. She's trained me so well. It's just one look and I'm down. I'm such a well-trained puppy. So I didn't go through this rebellious phase. I really didn't. And I'm very, very lucky. I think Renuka and me both agree that my mom and me have this, we've known each other for lifetimes. This is not our first lifetime together. And I think she's amazing, and world to one side, my mom to one side.
Yeah, that's true. What about you, Renuka, ma'am?
Same here. Even I, as I said, I didn't have any phase of rebellion because there was nothing that I needed to rebel against. It was so good that I would be a really horrible person to have wanted to rebel against, you know, perfection in a way. So that was the reason why I didn't go through that phase, and I therefore find it a bit shocking when my children do. But then I'm not.
I don't think I'm as cool as my mom to be. Yeah, exactly. I don't think I'm as cool as my mom.
Yeah.
To be very honest, and my daughter tells me that as well. That you know, if Nani had brought me up, I would be a different person today. So. Really? Tell me also, my daughter tells me, she's like, if Nani had brought me up, Nani would not be doing this. And she throws it in my face. Did Nani do this with you? No, no, then why are you doing this with me? So, yeah.
But coming to that, because you brought it up. So, parenthood has evolved over the years, and it has changed in so many ways. When you are a parent, how different are you from the way your parents have been to you, especially your mothers have been to you?
I think I'm quite different from my mother. Not for any other reason, but I feel that, my parents separated by the time I was 4.5. So my dad wasn't there on my daily, day-to-day living thing. And I mean, it's not only my opinion, it's us together that's doing this parenting thing. And to do this, to bringing up these two kids, and we are very much hands-on parents, both of us, I would say that. So Ajay and me together, we both have to agree on everything before, you know, we take it to the kids. And so we've done our best, that's all I can say. And we've tried very hard to give them the kind of principles and the ethics, and it's a different world today. I'll be very honest, it's a different world today from what it was when we were kids. I don't remember the media being there so much. I remember it being a much easier, freer world. I don't remember there being this threat of anything in our lives. There was no threat. I remember us as kids going to Lonavala, and we were told without a maid. We were told, "Acha, theek hai. You all have 3 hours. Go and play in the river and come back." Yeah. And nobody came looking for us. It could be 3 hours, 15 minutes. It could be 3 hours, 30 minutes. We had to come back for lunch. That was it. So, I mean, we never had this. There was and today I cannot even think about telling my son to go alone to the park, which is across the road. I would never even think of that. You know, it would be like, you know, okay, baby, take somebody with you, you know. And there are paps, and there's a different lifestyle that they have to contend with. So, yes, we are dealing with a completely different, set of a different world. I would say it's a different world, and of course the internet, which we didn't have at that point of time. So we were stupid. Kids are much smarter, much better informed. I mean, my mother could tell me shit and there was no way that I would be able to argue against it, because I didn't know better. Today my daughter knows better, my son knows better, and if they don't know better, there's Google always to help them out. So it's a different set of parenting structures, that, you know.
Absolutely.
So like I say, there is no manual.
Yeah, there's no manual. And in fact, even my mom says that if I was a mother today, I might not have been able to be such a cool mother, you know, because compared to her, I'm very overprotective of my kids, you know. I mean, I was not that protected, in the sense that I was made independent very early in life, but I can't think of that for my sons, because I have to teach them everything from not trusting strangers to cyberbullying to, you know, how to behave with girls. You know, I mean, the world is so complicated today. So,
and traveling by auto rickshaws and buses and trains and
you have to make them independent, but in a way that you know, kind of, I have to see to it that they are also protected properly. So, it is a big, big, you know, pressure. Let me say, which I don't think that my parents had.
Firstly, you know, when we talk about this new structure, like you said, there's the paparazzi culture, there's social media, there's cyberbullying, there's constant trolling. Today, you guys are on social media, you know. We are still at an age where we can handle it, and but you, like you said, that they're very impressionable at that age. When that kind of trolling or cyberbullying happens with kids, especially yours, does it break your heart a little more? Does it make, and being actors, being celebrities, you can't even respond and answer back to most of them, because that becomes mean. So, are you always caught in that double mind?
My children are not.
I think that's something that's like.
Yeah, sorry. Mine is
my daughter gets followed by the bats, and you know, you have comments posted, and she's had a few, you know, horrible things said to her, etc. And and the only thing that you can do at that point of time is to. You know, is to counsel them. You know, people talk crap and it's fine, and you know, they will talk crap because you matter to them. It's as simple as that. And you know, you can't let it matter to you to that extent. And you have to tell them that their opinion matters more and our opinion matters more than what some random person over there who you don't even know and will never know is seeing on some platform that you absolutely do not care about. So, I'll say this for the trolls. I feel like, you know, I really want to tell them to just get a life, you know. Tell them to be without their phones for a week. Tell them to get off Wi-Fi for a week and go and find some relationship that they actually care about. Or, you know, find some charity and good work to do instead of sitting online and, you know, making horrible remarks to people that, you know, who have never done anything to you. Or to buy it for children. I feel it's children. And especially the kids. They're like 13 and 14. What are you doing? You know?
Yeah, literally.
You know, when we always speak, I always make a point to say this, that women are the driving forces of nature. Women are the driving forces in this industry today. I think the ratio of men versus women is changing, and how, and it should only keep changing. This set is a testament to that. And all the best to you four incredible women who've come together to create this. I'm sure I'm going to love it. And I'm sure every man, every woman is going to love this show. And all the best.
Thank you. Thank you so much.